I would like you to take her to a world you only see on television. We see this challenging and sexy series like CSI Miami, CSI New York, and Bones. They give us an exciting look into the world of forensics, using state-of-the-art technology to solve crime. Now you may think, why don't we have this technology? Why don't we have it? Well, we do. The Netherlands Forensic Institute is the world-leading forensic institute. With our 700 dedicated professionals, we cover 40 forensic disciplines under one roof. Compared to the television series, yeah, it's a slight difference. On our crime scenes, no ladies with long blonde hair and high heels. So sorry, gentlemen. Our investigation lasts longer than 45 minutes, even if you include the commercial break. So, I'm a program director at the NFI, and we're always looking for new innovations. Just recently, I had a project, CSI The Hague. In this project, we digitized the crime scene, we virtualized the crime scene, and we were able to bring the crime scene to a court of law. I have a short video for you, and I'd like to show it now. This is a head-mounted device from the defense industry. With this device, we are able to digitize the crime scene, to store the information on a hard disk or in the device itself. We are now able to bring the crime scene in a court of law. Now the judge is able to test the witness statement. Normally, they can't do that because the court doesn't come to a crime scene. This is state-of-the-art technology. And for who's interested, this helmet was before the Google Glass. As a result of this project, I received an invitation to give a lecture in South Africa. In South Africa, I've learned there was a lack of knowledge on forensics, and they acknowledged this. So we started the cooperation. During my visit in South Africa, I had this dream. I had always this dream to bring our technology to developing countries. Now I could prove this dream in South Africa. You know, I started this journey in South Africa about 3 years ago. I didn't know anybody there. I was building on my network, gaining trust, building bridges, and yeah, you know, I was convincing them that we are not there for making quick money, but just to help them with our technology. And I had this dream, but it was a crazy dream. I had a stupid dream, and this dream was to establish the first forensic training institute in the whole of Africa. You know, I'm a governmental official, so my department won't give me approval. And no South African minister would say, well, Andro, here's $2 million, start with this. So, guess what? After 3 years of hard work, the Western Cape government said, here is a facility, 1,000 square meter, and together we will start the first forensic training institute in Africa. But that's not all. The Stellenbosch University, the most prestigious university from the whole continent, proposed to us to bring the whole project into their university. Now we can use their authorities, we can use the network, we can use the branding. The Hague Security Delta, a conglomerate of 300 companies in the Netherlands in the security industry, will use the facility as a hub to Africa and South Africa. So it's a very economical spin-off also. And the SADC countries, the 15 southern countries in Africa, who are also in need for forensic training, are also partnering now in this system. As we speak, 2 hours ago, I received an email from Mozambique asking if they can cooperate and use the facility for training. You know, talking about South Africa, as a black man, I want to share something with you. Just recently, now I'm very impressed about the improvement I saw in South Africa after apartheid. But just let me see A few months ago, I was in South Africa with my wife. She's a beautiful white lady. And we walked along the streets of beautiful Pretoria, and I said to her, can you imagine, just 30 years ago, our relation would be a criminal act, and I would be sentenced for 5-year jail. And now the Western Cape government welcomes us, and we're going to bring new technology for a safer society in Africa. What the NFI has accomplished is a very big value proposition. On the other hand, the companies will benefit and you'll create work. And on the other side, the Western Cape will get a very safe society. What I'm looking for is governmental organizations who are partnering us and help us to get this project done. Together, we can change the world. Together, we can make a safer South Africa. And look what dreams can accomplish. Thank you.